going to talk to you about the effects of photobiomodulation on one of the most abundant cell types in the oral cavity. So first of all, what is photobiomodulation? Photobiomodulation is the application of light at a low power output to an area of wounded or inflamed tissue to promote tissue healing and to reduce inflammation. So essentially, to put your gums in the spotlight to promote tissue healing. And to date, over 4,000 publications have been circulated detailing the efficacy of photobiomodulation in treating an array of diseases, including the chronic oral inflammatory disease, periodontitis. Periodontitis is a disease characterized by the loss of the structures surrounding and supporting the tooth, and can ultimately lead to tooth loss, and a staggering 40% of the UK adult population is affected by this disease. Hence, a non-invasive, novel therapeutic device could prove incredibly beneficial in reducing the prevalence of such a common disease. However, despite all the positive literature surrounding photobiomodulation, controversy still surrounds its application in practice, and this is due to a number of reasons. The first of which is the lack of consistency in the recording of treatment parameters. For example, authors should utilise a series of key parameters in their studies, including the wavelength of light employed and the power output of a light source. However, these are often misreported or not reported at all, making it incredibly difficult to compare literature currently published. Another key caveat is the lack of knowledge on how photobiomodulation elicits its molecular and cellular mechanisms. So, for example, we can see the clinical benefits of photobiomodulation, but we don't actually know what's happening in the body to cause it. So this project aimed to demonstrate the gold standard for photobiomodulatory research, to first of all fully characterise an LED array emitting wavelengths spanning the entirety of the visible spectrum from blue light all the way up to red light, to not only provide clear guidelines on how people should conduct their photobiomodulatory research, but to also ensure our research was reproducible, so our research could be compared with future publications. The next aim of the project was to determine the molecular and cellular mechanisms of photobiomodulation. And we actually found that blue light proved most beneficial in inducing a response from human gingival fibroblasts. And in fact, it caused increases in markers for wound healing, including increases in cell proliferation and increases in growth factors, and also decreases in markers for inflammation, including the pro-inflammatory cytokine interleukin-8. So in conclusion, we have found that not only we have a fully characterized system for use in photobiomodulatory studies, but also that something as simple as light could prove incredibly beneficial in reducing inflammation in diseases including periodontitis and possibly beyond. Thank you.
So why do you think that photobiomodulation is eliciting IL-8 from fibroblasts? What is happening to the cells?
So specifically, photobiomodulation acts directly upon the mitochondria. So it upregulates mitochondrial activity by upregulating a specific complex of the electron transport chain, which induces increases in secondary messages, including ATP, and increases in reactive oxygen species. And this modulates the activation of NF-kappa-B, which is directly regulates pro-inflammatory cytokines, such as interleukin-8.
Is this approach used in medicine in any other areas of healthcare?
Yeah, it's used incredibly widely, actually. It's been used to treat lower back pain, pain in rheumatoid arthritis, as it's supposed to have an analgesic effect, as well as an anti-inflammatory effect. It's used across the board, basically, yeah.
So it's in general use?
Not in general use. There's trials utilising it. I think it's used quite often in practice in Brazil, for dental purposes, but it's still, there's a lot of clinical trials still, yeah.
Lower back pain?
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you. If we can't get people to brush their teeth, how are we going to get them to shine lights on their teeth?
I think the... That's a really good question. I think the key thing will be the simplicity of the design and the fact that people might think, oh, wow, all I have to do is shine a light on my teeth and it'll solve all my problems. That's brilliant. So the main thing that we would think, and this is way down the line, is to potentially create a mouth guard just to insert. And it, you know, you could do it for, like, what, 4 minutes a day? Just walk around with it for a bit so it's just a little bit less invasive. But I do still think that you will have to brush as well to remove the plaque. So it doesn't negate the use of brushing. Thank you.